We're in the middle of a data-driven revolution. Biology is now working with huge amounts of data generated from living systems, and we need to analyse and make sense of that data. And to do that, we need to bring together expertise right across the breadth of biology, together with physical scientists and computational scientists, and that's what we're doing in the Precision Biosciences Innovation Hub. And this will allow us to solve some of the most important global challenges that we face today. So precision bioscience is the application of advanced, data-driven technologies to provide the deepest possible understanding of biological systems, complex biological systems. This whole new data-driven approach is allowing for incredible work to be done.
In our lab, we study soil and plant microbiomes in order to increase sustainability in agriculture and also to provide for better food security. One of our projects is the Wessex Basin Digital Twin Project. In this project, we study soil microbiomes at a large scale. The digital twin model allows us to simulate different interventions without having to do them actually in the field. This allows us to assess different approaches to see if they will improve or if they have negative effects on soil health.
In this lab, we will use single-cell sequencing to generate data that we can put into computational models to understand why one cell fate is one way and one is another. And then we can predict which gene regulatory networks we need to target in order to change cell fate in a certain direction. Our society is aging, and with age comes increased risk factors for many diseases. So rather than simply trying to treat the symptoms of aging, we could try to de-age cells, rejuvenate the population so that we get a much healthier lifespan and reduce the burden on our healthcare systems.
Usually, to diagnose infection, what is done is bacteria are grown on agar plates, and this usually takes several days. But what we've been working on here is speeding that process up to a couple of minutes. So the idea is that over time, we could quickly diagnose infection and then recommend treatment within the same few minute window. We're starting to use AI to turn this methodology into a predictive diagnostic tool that can detect and treat threats as they arise.
This is not just for academic papers and academic research. This is about real solutions to real problems. And we're also working together with our industry partners. So for example, we're working with the National Biofilms Innovation Centre that connects universities with more than 300 industry partners. So the world faces some really significant problems, and the Precision Bioscience Innovation Hub will provide an advanced infrastructure that will allow us to bring together all of that capability and interdisciplinary science that will allow us to address some of the most important questions.